On the inside, you will find a photo of Masoud Tahan. He is an ISIS recruiter in Syria. Mrs. Florida, do you need help?
No, I'm good.
In the past 2 years, 8 Americans, 10 Brits, and 2 dozen Belgians have joined ISIS due to Tahan's efforts. They credit his recruitment on social media.
Mr. Tahan limits his appeals to the religious importance of ISIS establishing a caliphate. He hasn't specifically promoted violence.
However, his recruits have been behind some of the worst atrocities we've seen in Iraq and Syria. Beheadings, bombings, rape.
And what do you need from us?
We know Tahan's location for the next 48 hours. You have been selected to give the administration legal justification to kill him. The threshold question is this. Does an ISIS recruiter rise to the level of enemy combatant?
Is that the only way this guy makes it onto the kill list?
Yes, if we want to avoid blowback, not just political, but legal.
Has he ever fired a gun or killed anyone?
No, not to our knowledge.
But his recruits have. His recruits have killed hundreds. Tahan's posted dozens of online calls to join ISIS. Sleuthway, YouTube, Telegram.
But has he ever espoused violence?
No.
Well, the fact that he doesn't overtly espouse violence just shows how sophisticated ISIS has become.
But how do you judge that? He talks about establishing the caliphate, which makes him more of a preacher than anything
ISIS
else.
ISIS isn't a religion. It's a terrorist group with one goal, which is to convert or kill anyone.
Yes, but Tahan isn't actually doing these things. It's his recruits.
Why are you protecting him, Captain?
I'm not protecting anyone. I'm thinking of the message it sends to other nations if we call a recruiter an enemy combatant. Once we do that, what's next? Targeting imams, college professors.
When they advocate violent attacks on Americans, yes.
And what's the pushback on Putin when he says he can take out a Ukrainian YouTube star who he claims is an agitator?
If the YouTube star is telling people to go to Paris and shoot up concert halls, I say go Putin.
The United States has always held that a propagandist is not a combatant and is therefore immune from targeted killing.
No.